All right. And now, Mark Presson, executive editor for CNN Politics, Jamie Gangel, CNN special correspondent, Nia Malika Henderson, our senior political reporter, Michael Nutter, the former mayor of Philadelphia, Kayleigh McEnany, conservative columnist, and Laura Coates, a former federal prosecutor and CNN legal analyst. Mark, this is a stunning announcement. All right. And I think I made the point there at the very beginning, that statement just breaking from Julian Assange. You have Julian Assange basically saying Manning is a hero and President Obama, you know, by default is a hero for freeing her.
Well, yeah, in many ways, and we'll hear from Barack Obama directly tomorrow when he holds his final news conference. I mean, I was surprised. I think that probably a lot of people sitting here on this panel was surprised. What I find even more surprising, though, is that some of the critics, though, of the release of Chelsea Manning are the same ones who are not coming out and being as forceful about the Russians hacking into our systems. It's just a very bizarre situation that we're in right now. It's quite frankly where you're seeing Democrats who are, you know, the law and order political party when it comes to the Russians. And then, quite frankly, the Republicans, when it comes to Chelsea Manning, they're the ones that are law and order. It's very bizarre.
And Laura, what do you make about this? What happens next here? Because there is a great irony, as she pointed out, in the fact that Donald Trump may be the one to have to deal with Julian Assange coming here, which would uncover, of course, anything Julian Assange was doing related to Donald Trump and the Russians.
You know, I think that's the fascinating point here, because remember, what they're talking about is they want to make sure that people are brought to justice and have due process, not focus on the outcome necessarily. And the thought is that because Chelsea Manning faced some form of due process, that to commute it, not pardon it, remember, but to commute it and acknowledge it's still a conviction is enough. But with Assange, we haven't had that opportunity in the United States to say whether or not this person has done something wrong, should be brought to justice. And I mean, Sweden is the one to try to extradite him for something totally different than we're trying to do. So I think this is going to be very telling to figure out what Donald Trump's plans are in terms of whether he views Russia as an adversary and whether or not he wants people who have aided and abetted Russia in some form to be brought to justice in the United States.
And Kayleigh, that is the big question here that Donald Trump has to face, because, well, it used to be that Julian Assange was a bipartisan issue, although, as Mark points out, now when it comes to Russia, it's a little bit more split. But Donald Trump isn't going to have a lot of friends if he doesn't want to bring Julian Assange here.
And I think he will. Look, Donald Trump applauded the fact that the Democrats were exposed, that the DNC was exposed for what they are, setting up the candidacy of Hillary Clinton at the expense of Bernie Sanders. He applauded that. But what he does not applaud, and what he will never applaud, and what Obama has tacitly endorsed by this commutation of the sentence, is the leaking of sources and methods information, the most highly classified information that put American lives in danger. Like Tom Cotton said, I was over there fighting in Afghanistan while this man, while Private Manning, this woman, Private Manning, was leaking information to undermine the United States. It is serious, and today is a very sad day because Obama sent a message, you can do this and get away with a 7-year sentence.
All right. Thank you all very much. We are going to take a break. When we